ప్రపన్నపాదిజాతాయ తోత్రవేత్రైకపాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుఖే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ అండ్ బెస్ట్ విషెస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. శ్రీమద్ భగవద్గీత వర్స్ నంబర్ 12 ఆఫ్ సెకండ్ చాప్టర్. శ్రీ భగవానువాచ నత్వే వాహం జాతు నాసం నత్వం నేమే జనాధిపాః నచైవ న భవిష్యామః సర్వే వయమతః పరం. వి హావ్ స్టార్టెడ్ దిస్ వర్స్ yesterday itself. We also saw death cannot separate myself from me. Even birth cannot separate. Therefore, this self which is known as Atma is free from birth and death. Because death affects us. Now Krishna wants to bring one more beautiful subject which is known as logic. In our ancient times, this logic was a separate educational system. It has got its own system because mind is a slave of logic. If somebody says, today morning it was raining, we won't accept. Unknowingly, the mind will take the attention of the roads. Is there water? Is there moisturizing? If there is no moisture, no water, you won't accept the statement which he made. Because mind works with the logic. The same, this approachment, that which is endowed with logic, will bring problem too. That's what Krishna says. Let us understand what exactly. Now first, this Tarka Shastra, they introduce four kinds of absence. In Sanskrit, they call it abhavaha. Abhavaha means absence. We also can say abhavam, absence. You know, absence doesn't have an existence. But that absence only is experienced in our mind. Therefore, it is valid. Now, what are those four absences? There are not four absences because the mind has a tendency to experience in various state. Therefore, it is divided into four absences. Now, if I bring a clay, a bunch of clay, let me make a pot out of it. I made a pot. Now, you can say, normally what we say, the pot was not there 10 minutes before. But Tarka person will say, the absence of pot was there 10 minutes before. Isn't it? Now, why Tarka person, he says, he will come to us and will say, sir, you experience the existence of the pot now. Because you experience the existence of pot now, you confirm the absence of the pot 10 minutes ago. Therefore, I can also say, there was the absence before the creation of the pot. This is the mind which plays like this. Now you seem to be confused a little bit. Why should we study this absence? Because absence brings impact. If somebody becomes so close to you, that somebody, if he leaves you after 1 or 2 years, even not that much duration is needed, after 10 days, you people were very close, you shared everything, you shared all kinds of experience in your life. After 10 days, you got separated. Now, this mind will miss him. The missing something is the characteristic of mind. This is not only human being, even animals, they do. When we go out of our home for a week, after coming back, you might have noticed the pet animals which come fast and which will be showing their love at least for 10 minutes. The mind is endowed with the tendency to miss something. Now that person's absence is experienced, but with painful nature. The person was not there 10 days before. That absent was not bothering you. Now it bothers. Therefore, Tarka Shastra says, that absent is different than this absence. It's a kind of peculiar approach. Therefore, I said in the beginning itself, because mind has got the nature to become slave, to bring more different experiences with the different circumstances of absence. Therefore, it is being divided into four. The next one, they call it the absence after destruction. The first absence is known as prak abhava. Prak means before. Prak abhava, srishtehe prak abhava. The absence before creation. Then absence after pralaya, destruction. If I crush the pot which I made, now there is no pot. That's what we say. But Tarka person will say, now the absence of pot after destruction. Because different, both are different. You have to go for the example. The person who came, then he went back. Even a friendship. Therefore, this both absence are not the same. Okay, what is the third one? The third one is anyonya abhavaha. For example, if you take an apple and an orange, the Tarka person will say, we will say, orange is not apple. Apple is not orange. That's what we will say. But he will say, we find absence of an apple on orange. The absence of orange is found in the apple. Because it seems to be very peculiar when we make into a sentence, but mind works. Therefore we say, my husband is not like my father. My wife is not like my mother. It means what? You found the absence of your mother in your spouse, your father into your spouse. That's the mind. This mind is, it seems to be very intelligent, but it's very idiotic nature. Bhagavan Krishna says, be careful with your mind. It says before birth you were not there. It says before your birth you were not there means what? This, the absence was experienced. Is it experienced? No, imagined. The same mind will say that you are not there in the sleep. Were you not there? Are you not there in the sleep? Is it so? After getting up from the sleep, we say, I had a very sound sleep. What does it mean? Sound sleep means with the stereo and all. It's a language. Sound sleep means the deep sleep. When I was in the deep sleep, where? I don't know. Are you there in the sleep? Yes, of course, I was there. What your mind says? Mind says, my absence were there. That is the mind. Therefore, this tarka, we cannot deny it. We need this approachment. Anyonya bhavaha means these objects absent is found on this one. The object of the absence of this object found in this object. We say apple is not an orange, orange is not an apple. But the absence of apple is it can be experienced on orange. Therefore, we replace always object. The mind is not ready. When it is attached with some object, it won't ready to get away from that object. If a kid is playing with a toy, if the toy is broken, you replace another toy, it will cry a lot. In the same way, the kid after being matured, the tendency of sticking with the object is continuous. Krishna says, be careful. Now we have seen three kinds of absence. Prak abhavaha, pradvamsa abhavaha, anyonya abhavaha. Then what? The third, fourth one is atyanta abhavaha. There are words we use in our day-to-day life, like rabbit horn, sky flower. Is there anything that called a rabbit horn? Rabbit is there, horn is there. We don't find together. But that word is there, object, it was never there. Now also it is not there, it is not going to be there in the future. Atyanta abhavaha, absolute absence. Even in three tenses, it was not there in the past, it is not there at present, it won't be there in the future. That is the meaning. Sky flower, it never had its existence, only absence. Because some things, you know, the mind feels, it always endowed with the fear of death, which was never there. Do you know, when people die, they get relief from the pain. Death is not the painful thing. It seems to be the trick of the mind. Mind plays lots of tricks. In fact, it cheats because it is limited, dependent on only five sense organs. The sense organs are limited. Therefore, what? Mind constructs more buildings like anumana, pramana, means inferences. First step inference, second step inference, third step inference. This anumana, arthapati, upamana, these are all the evident way of establishing a knowledge through our mind. Therefore, Krishna says, this Atma, which is in the form of I in you, which is experienced always, is free from all these abhavas. There was a never time, Arjuna, you and me were not there. Even the same thing with those kings. Now you can see people are here, and there won't be any time you and me are not going to be there. This is because of your mind. It's very hard to digest for us even. Because this logical approachment, it can confirm your buddhi, but emotionally we won't accept it. The fact remains fact. Therefore, whatever is said in this verse, it is the fact. First, we have to understand that death cannot separate me from me. That understanding should come from this verse. Then what is separated? That comes in the next verse. What is being separated when I die? What exactly the death means? Is it that I am losing everything, including myself? Shastra says, no, never, sir. You cannot lose yourself because the self is eternal. In forthcoming verses, he will give more and more valid points you cannot deny at all. We cannot deny it. When Krishna says, this Atma, yourself, is free from all this Abhavaha. The self is free from Prak Abhavaha, means before birth, your mind says you were not there, your absence was there, it is not there. Double negative becomes positive. I was there before my birth. Before my creation, it means my birth, I was there. Now I am there. I will be there. And finally, this Atma never goes into an absent entity. It cannot. Now you see, the glory of this knowledge is, you think, Arjuna, they are going to die. They are not going to die. Their shariras, which is going to perish. Because the nature of the sharira is going to perish. That's what he is going to bring in the next verse. That we will see now.
Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Dehi Nosmin Yatha Dehe Kaumaram Yavvanam Jara Tatha Dehantara Praptihi Dhirastatrana Mukhyati.
Which is separated from me during death? Now, first of all, death for whom? Now, a person, when he dies, the people around his person, they experience the absence of that person. Not that person who is going to experience the absence of person. Now, death means, in one more text, death experience is not to the person who dies, the persons who are around his body. Because they are going to miss, not that person. He will get one more sharira. He will get one more. He will get means he will be provided one more sharira. That's what the confirmation he gives. Death is not an end. Okay. Now here, Asmin dehe, dehinaha, kavmaram yavanam jara. This deha, the sharira, even there is a question. When this jiva, the consciousness, comes into our sharira? Because when you make an horoscope, I have to bring this point, you know. This horoscope is fixed or written on the time which we are born. Now, which time should be written? The people say that the when baby's head is seen first from mother's womb, when head comes out, that is the time we can predict horoscope. But one more method, when this navel, the muscles are disconnected, the tube, you know, that knows when it is disconnected, that is the time we could predict the horoscope. Because this horoscope is a science, we cannot deny it. This is the time I have to say. So your birth, you are given a sharira. That sharira is given. It was not like that, you were not there. Now you have the body to experience about you. This is like bringing mirror under the sun. See, when you bring the mirror under the sun, now you got one more reflection. Means the reflection of sun is seen now. You cannot say that now the reflection, now the sun is arrived, manifested. You cannot say that. It was there, the rays of sun, it was there before bringing this, the mirror. Like this body is a mirror through which we can experience ourselves. It will come in future. But here I have to say what horoscope is. It's a complete science. And people are there who don't accept horoscope. Horoscope is a method to predict how the life is going to be. When a baby is born, for example, if now a baby is born in this place, this is east, this is west, then this is south and this is north. Okay? Now, the baby, when it is born here, the astrologer looks on the sky. He divides sky into 12 houses. He fixes the east is the first house. The west is the seventh house. The south is the fourth house. The north is the 10th house. You can check what I say now. Go and check your horoscope. If a baby is born 6 o'clock in the morning, the sun should be in the first house. If the baby is born in the evening by 6 o'clock, the sun has to be in the 7th house. If the baby is born by 12 o'clock afternoon, the sun is to be in the 12th house. If the baby is born night, during night 12 o'clock, your sun has to be, the sun in the horoscope, the planet sun, to be in the 4th house. And all remaining houses, you can divide the timings. It's a very precious science. And according to the transit of the planet, so you get a kind of experience, different experiences. This is a science. By seeing the planetary position, an astrologer, it's a complete math by our Shastra. We used to do in order to fix a time for auspicious events. Therefore, when a jiva, a baby is born, they predict what to be done. And people say that your guru is not well placed. It's a kind of science. We use the positions of those planets. We need not blame them. That's what the proper understanding. And every planet also, it has got its own nature. That I'm going to give a separate class. Definitely. Every planet has got its own tendency. It means it's an absolute science. Through what we predict is nothing but about our life. If we accept this is a kind of science, we can utilize it. That's what horoscope is. Now here he is introducing what is removed from our death is this sharira, sir. We have three kinds of shariras. This is called gross body, which is dropped during death. That's what that death is. Death is removing, means dropping this physical system. That's what he says. Then what about this physical system? This physical system which is endowed with six kinds of modifications. That we will see tomorrow in the next episode. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.